our CNN Supreme Court reporter, Ariane DeVogue, and CNN election analyst Rick Hasen join me now. Ariane, I want to start with you. In this Pennsylvania case, Justice Alito said this: "I reluctantly conclude that there is simply not enough time at this late date to decide the question before the election." Does that mean we're done? It came too late? Or does the before the election part leave open the possibility that they can come back on these same issues after the election?
Right. Well, here where we were with Pennsylvania. Pennsylvania had to do with a state Supreme Court decision, right? And basically, it had come up to the court two times. The first time, they had deadlocked, and Roberts basically sided with the liberals. And then the Republicans who brought this challenge, they knew that Barrett was on the court, so they decided to try again. And what Alito said is, it's too close to the election. But he noted that in Pennsylvania, they're segregating out the ballots. And he said it wouldn't be too late. We could review this after the election on a shortened time frame. But John, that would mean a lot. It would mean that the election came down to that state. It would mean that those particular ballots would count. So it's unlikely that that would occur, but he made a point there to say he is leaving that possibility open.
Leaving that possibility open. Yes. And so, Rick, do you see any pattern so far? There have been three Supreme Court decisions about counting in battleground states: Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, and North Carolina. Democrats were not happy in Wisconsin. They're more happy about the Pennsylvania and North Carolina decisions here. Do you see a pattern emerging from this court, or are the cases too different, whether it's about a federal court issue or the legislative issue, to really know what would happen when we get other cases reach the court maybe after the election?
Well, we know from the Wisconsin case that there's a majority on the court that does not want to see changes in election rules coming from federal courts, especially close to the election. Where the court seems more closely divided, as Ariane suggested, is in cases coming up from state courts where the constitutional question is somewhat different. I do think, you know, trying to read the tea leaves, you know, the big unanswered question is whether Justice Barrett would participate in any post-election challenge. And if she did, would she side with the most conservative justices who believe that state legislatures have kind of unfettered power to decide what the rules are going to be for elections, even if they violate their own state constitutions as decided by their state Supreme Courts? It's a pretty different theory about power than we've seen from the Supreme Court before.
And that point, Ariane, is what progressives are very nervous about. They read the Kavanaugh decision in the Wisconsin case. They're worried about this scenario where the president says at midnight or 1 a.m. on election night, okay, we're done. I'm leading. Don't count any more ballots. Anything counted, you know, after now is fraudulent. It's going to be rigged. They're going to sneak in ballots and so on. And they seize on this from Kavanaugh in the Wisconsin decision. Those states want to avoid the chaos and suspicions of impropriety that can ensue if thousands of absentee ballots flow in after election day. You know, those who support voting rights say, no, it happened. This is, as long as it's within state law, that's how it happens. You count them, people watch, it's fine. Does the progressives say that tells them that this court will try to back up the president if he tries to do that?
Well, that's what was so interesting, because Kavanaugh's words in that case really did seem to mirror the president. And he basically said, look, some states want to have these deadlines. Deadlines are important to block any kind of chaos and get these votes counted election night. But of course, many states don't do that. But what I think was really interesting is how Barrett got out of things last night. She didn't recuse, right? Because that's what the Democrats asked. They asked before that she didn't get involved in any election cases. She didn't do that. She basically said, look, I need more time to get read in. Her vote is going to be so critical. And that was such an interesting move last night, because that means she may participate down the road again, maybe in the Pennsylvania case, but her very first vote on this Supreme Court won't be in these really contentious cases. So you're absolutely right. I think she's key, and I think it's very interesting how, like Rick said, the conservatives really tipped their hand about where they're going down the road, and it would be a big shift.
And Rick, this may be more of a political question than a legal question, but I'm going to try it with you anyway. One of the questions has been, if the president does something like that, comes out on election night and says, stop counting, I'm ahead, I don't trust any count after now, would other Republicans stand up to him? Listen to this from the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell.
We're going to have a thoroughly credible election here. We're going to have an accurate election across the country. It may not be known election night. And the American people are going to decide who they want to run their government for the next couple of years.
thoroughly credible election. Might not be done on election night. Those are the responsible words that I think a lot of people want to hear. Are you convinced that if the president starts asking for things that are outside of that, that people will stand up to him?
Well, look, I think a lot depends on the margin. If this is a blowout for Biden, which is possible given the polling, then I think Republicans are going to say, you know, let's let the process play out, and, you know, the kind of shenanigans that the president might pull, that will just fall to the side. Where this stuff would really matter is if it's a really close election in the Electoral College, and say it comes down to a very close race in Pennsylvania, and there's Trump alleging fraud and rigging the election, that's where I think Republicans are going to look and see, is there a way to try to use the courts or use the political process to win this very narrow election? That's the circumstance I think that people are most worried about.
Well, we'll certainly watch all this play out in the days ahead, and grateful to have you both to help us. Rick Hasen, Ariane, Vogue, thank you so much.